Well, it's been a while. You guys are probably wondering where I've been. Well, don't worry. I'm still alive. Oh, and Brutus is here, too.
Yeah, I'm here, too.
So, yeah, welcome to Austin Nation TV. Let's start the show. My cock is much bigger than
yours. My cock can walk right through the door. God damn it. Well, if your ears were bleeding from the last 2 year-end videos, fear not, because we're done with the worst of the year. We're done with the absolute trash, the absolute garbage that came out in 2019. Now we're going to look at the actual good stuff that came out in 2019. Stuff that is soothing to the ears and to the listeners, and that is definitely something that is, you know, cherished and will be remembered, as 2019 was a pretty good year for music as well. A lot of bands made comebacks, and metal and rock were reaching the charts more than I think I've seen it ever in a while. A lot of metal bands were definitely out there this year, and it was very cool to see. Definitely very cool. Yeah, I got 30 songs here that I think were the best. Let's get it started.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
So I know I didn't like his album that much, and this didn't appear on an album. It was just kind of like a one-off single thing and done. But Churches and Marshmallows Here With Me is definitely a different tone as to what, I'm used to hearing. Every day, you're saying the words that I want you to say. You know, for Marshmallow, the little electronic stuff that he does wasn't too obnoxious, and Churches put their own little spin on things, and I thought it was great, and it really did the work it needed to do, and for a 2.5 minute song, it's catchy, and just one that got stuck in my head after the first couple of listens.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
So I didn't see or hear of this person until I went and saw Paramore in concert last July. There was two openers, one was Foster the People, and the other one was Soccer Mommy, and I'm going, okay, I don't know this band. Come to find out it's a solo persona of, oh god, what's her name? I think her name's Sophie or something. And listening to her in concert, I was like, this is good. This is cool. It sounds like very cool indie rock. And I listened to her debut album, Clean. Thought that was very well put together and different. And she released this new song this year that is dark and intriguing. So Lucy is basically talking about Lucifer coming up from the depths of hell and just taking Miss Sophie with him to hell. Because she's suffering already, so why not just kind of, you know, let it go? The dark atmosphere I think is what really attaches it for me. It definitely wants you to feel like you are a part of the conversation and whatnot. It rules. It rules.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Bring Me the Horizon had a big year. They changed a lot in sound, definitely, but they had some rock tunes, and this was one of them. We're so full of when Sugar, Honey, Ice, and Tea came out, it was definitely one of the ones I said they should make this a single. Because even though Bring Me the Horizon had gone more poppier, they still had the rock-driven tracks like Mantra, Wonderful Life, and the random heavy part, the breakdown at the end of Heavy Metal. I mean, sure, whatever, that was cool. This song was definitely cool. I mean, the use of the, what is it, acronym of shit was used very well, because Ali said it was something that, you know, his dad used to say. Instead of saying curse words, he would kind of, you know, use that kind of stuff, and I mean, yeah, it leaves me catchy, and I love how it goes from, like, fast-paced, like, kind of, like, punkier side to the more poppier side where it gets a little warped synth in there, and Ollie Sykes' vocals go from, like, 5 to 10 within a matter of minutes. It rocks and should be, I think, should be the biggest hit off of the album. I really do, because it goes in 100 different directions, but it does it in a good way.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
This is a 2019 year-end list, so you're probably not surprised with Machine Gun Kelly, but, Motley Crue made the list? Give me the dirt. biggest Motley Crue fan. I think I hear a lot of their stuff, mainly from, you know, like, my dad and all this. He's a big Motley Crue guy. And I was actually the one that told him about this song. And it's for the movie of the same name, obviously. And I gotta say, it was cool. I like Machine Gun Kelly's part. I think Vince Neil can still wail a little bit more than we thought he could, even though he's definitely, like Axl Rose, gained some LBs. But, you know, that's what happens when you get old. It's okay. And they've announced that they're going to be coming back in 2020 for more tours. It's just kind of weird, the time we're in. It's like flashing back to the 80s and 90s all of a sudden, and early 2000s with these bands that have been pretty much gone for years that have just decided, hey, you know what? Let's do this again. And Motley Crue's definitely one of them. And hopefully they put out something just as good.
Burger King foot lettuce.
So Eminem's still up and kicking. I don't know if you knew that. Kamikaze was a definite step up from Revival. I loved it, even though it dissed a lot of music critics and just other people in general. The beats, the flow were so much better. Then he decided to team up with Logic, and they just went off. Fuck rap, bustle like an addict with a semi-automatic. Who'd have had it and he ready for anybody to buck back? Hold on, catch a vibe, ain't no way in hell we leaving nobody alive. Even suicide, no, fuck that. Bobby feeling villainous, he killing us. I mean, the speed from both of them is ridiculous. I mean, Logic gets a lot of hate, and I get it. But there's just no denying this song. I love the beat. I use the instrumental on my Crap Rap series. I think I'm going to continue doing that. I'm not sure. But I don't know. There's something about those two teaming up together that just really was awesome. It was like a dream collab that we didn't even know we needed. Eminem spits his verse. Chris D'Ella comes in with a joke verse at the end, imitating, like, older Eminem. That was pretty funny. But yeah, it's a fun song, and just basically calling out the haters on both sides.
Burger King foot lettuce.
Yeah, Fall Out Boy, Weezer, and Green Day are all going on tour in 2020 together for the Hella Mega Tour, and I am so stoked I'm going. Hands up. And this is one of the new songs they decided to put on there called Dear Future Self, Hands Up, featuring Wyclef Jean. It's, for what it wasn't bad. I mean, it was definitely better than stuff off of Mania, which I didn't think was too bad, but it definitely was, yeah, underwhelming. And, you know, it's just fun, and Wyclef Jean definitely fits as to where I felt like more of their other features, they were just kind of trying to throw things in there, but Wyclef Jean does a good job at picking it up. Patrick Stump keeps his soul vocals going in a rather upbeat and happy song from them, which is weird because they're definitely still that emo depressed group in them despite the pop direction, but this was happy and cheerful.
Burger King foot lettuce.
So Attention Attention by Shinedown just doesn't seem to want to go away. Monsters is a hit, and a big one at that. 'Cause my monsters are real. Yeah, I mean, it might be radio friendly for some people's liking, but when has Shinedown really not been that radio friendly? They've had that dark feel to them their whole entire life, but they play a lot of their songs on the radio. I mean, would you rather listen to Shinedown or would you rather listen to Seether? Pick one, because in the end, I think Shinedown wins this by a mile. It's not even close. Monsters definitely shows you the what basically everybody is thinking in their whole entire lives, because even though we might be a good person and whatnot, we still all have those demons, that monsters that haunt us, and, you know, we're just left kind of questioning ourselves in the end and basically trying to hide the monster that that keeps plaguing us.
Burger King foot lettuce.
Blink-182 surprised on their album 9. I gotta give them that. The kickoff track will definitely prove it. Right here. There ain't nothing like the first time. Taking all the nights up, sleeping with the friends. Fight out in the air, there ain't nothing like the first time. It's very unusual because it has that same kind of like verse that you would hear from Blink-182, and the chorus was one of their catchier ones and one of their better ones I had heard in years. It reminded me a lot of Enema of the State, Take Off Your Pants and Jacket, Days of Blink-182. Then there's a little trap beat part right when Matt Skiba starts singing. Which isn't very Blink-182 like, but I'm like, you know what? It fits. It adds something to the song. Like, I feel like if it was just Travis Barker doing that little thing with his drums, it would have been boring. But with that beat in the back, you're just kind of like, okay, all right, I can sing along to this. It's 2.5 minutes long, and it kicks off the album perfectly, kind of telling you, hey, everything's cheerful and okay, and then kind of going like into, I wish I was happy. Oh, Lord. Oh, God. And it just gets depressing. And depressing and depressing as we finish off the album. So it is definitely a good one. A mood setter in a weird way, because everything goes completely reverse after that. But it gets you attached. It keeps you wanting to listen to more.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
The song has grown on me. Seasons change and I love it cold. Feed the flame cause we can let go. Yeah. One of his bigger hits on his album, Hollywood's Bleeding. I gotta say, I may have been wrong about this song. This is definitely a pop song by Post Malone, not one of his rap songs. But, you know, I can't be too mad at it. It fits what he's known for doing, which is switching back and forth between hip-hop and pop music. You know, and I think he's one of the few rappers that can really sing. I mean, he does a good job on this track. He really lets it out, and it does well.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Weird collab of the year number one. When I found you, I found me. Well, I think it's really the only weird collab on here. There was a lot. Like Corey Taylor collabing with, I think his name was like Kid Bookie or something, a rapper. And then we have A Day to Remember collabing with Marshmello. Yeah, you heard me correctly. But you know what I gotta say to this? Even though it might be that same obnoxious little electronic beat that Marshmello puts out in all of his songs, A Day to Remember actually rock it out. I love when their instruments kick in. I find it catchy and just a banger. All the way, I was just hoping that A Day to Remember's solo work, like Degenerates, would be a lot better coming up, but I hate to say it, their song they did with Marshmello is better than their own fucking track. And that says a lot, considering Marshmello's album was pure hot garbo. But this one was actually one of the gems on it.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
I've said before, indie rock is really hit or miss, and American Football has always been one that has intrigued me. Their first album was great, their second album was underwhelming, and they came at us with their third album, and the lead-off single for this album featured a familiar face that I talk about on this channel. The lessons are so much less obvious. Hayley Williams of Paramore appears on this track. You know, while Paramore's taking a break from doing things and whatnot, you know, she's off doing her own thing, and of course, I mean, if you want a sad and dreary song on an indie rock album, definitely call her, because then you'll get something like this. They kind of put a twist on Pink Floyd's Comfortably Numb, because the chorus part, the end of the chorus part's kind of the same as it. They just change it from Comfortably Numb to Uncomfortably Numb. And the duet-style singing between the two singers, Hayley Williams and, you know, what's-his-face, definitely just do very, very well. It just sounds so beautiful mixed together, and everything about it just keeps you wanting more. It's got that dark feel to it, and it doesn't stop.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Yeah, I prevail. You know what? I'm not worthy. Where did this band come from? Apparently they had an album out before Trauma that I didn't know about. Bow Down kicks it off. Once I put in the CD and heard this, I was like, good Lord, we're in for a ride, and it's gonna be a good one. And it was a good one. Holy fucking shit.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Post Malone with Goodbyes. We're both acting insane, but you're stopping to change. Now I'm drinking again. 80 proof in my veins, and my fingertips stained. Well, and Young Thug, but I kind of, you know, ditch Young Thug from the song, because if it wasn't for Young Thug, the song would be a lot better and probably a lot higher than it is, but Young Thug ruins it. It's one of those songs where the feature just ruins the whole entire goddamn song, but Post Malone does a good job. I like his flow in this. Chorus is catchy as hell. I loved the music video, by the way, too. That was very artistic and creative, but, you know, I mean, it's your typical Post Malone track, and it bodes well.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
In a year where Denzel Curry did this. Go ahead now! We also get a pretty decent rock track from him named Ricky. My daddy said trust no man but your brothers and never leave your day ones in the gutter. I mean, I was gonna put that Bulls on Parade cover on here, but I was like, yeah, I'm gonna stick to studio versions because that's technically still a live version and it did go viral, but and it was badass, but Ricky is a definite banger, and also Bulls on Parade, the only studio version is by the Rage Against the Machine, Denzel Curry. I think you should get on recording a studio version of your cover, but, you know, Ricky's fine, I can take Ricky, cool 2.5 minutes, great beat, great flow, catchy, everything I want in a song, at least a rap song. It just, when it gets stuck in my head as many times as it did, it definitely deserves to be on this list.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Who would have thunk that Ed Sheeran would be on my year-end best list at the end of the year? No? Nobody? Pull my trigger, let me blow your mind. Blow with Chris Stapleton and Bruno Mars by Ed Sheeran as well. They all do so well. Bruno Mars kills it on drums and guitar. Chris Stapleton does his thing. And Ed Sheeran, the grouchy vocals work for this song for him. Like, why can't you do more of this? Like, I know the song is about a girl getting down and, mouthing your willy, but it's just, I was surprised listening to the song. I'm like, this is Ed Sheeran? Really? The guy who wrote Shape of You, the guy who just plays an acoustic guitar and sings something, this is Ed Sheeran? Wow.
Number 15.
Bring Me the Horizon, Go Electronic. Nothing new, but different. Listen to the floor. So after toying with it in albums like Suicide Season, There Is a Hell, and Sepeternal, Bring Me the Horizon have fully come to terms that we want to do this. So they brought Grimes in for their track Nihilist Blues, and I gotta say, dark tracks, it's the dark tracks that get me. Love it. At first listen, I was very like, but listening to it more and more, I was like, you know, this is a very well put together EDM song. And I never thought I'd be saying that with Bring Me the Horizon, but Ollie Sykes does good. I think his and Grimes' vocals go together very well, and when his vocals are all toyed with, it's fun. I love the beat that kicks in, and it's just, it's great. It's 5.5 minutes, it really serves a purpose, really does its thing. You know, you get the band that comes in with the instrumentals as well. It's just an all-around, almost perfect song that is definitely year-end material.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Corn Explode Back. You'll never find me. I mean, it definitely had that, the beginning, you could definitely feel it being a Korn song, and then all of a sudden it explodes into more. I love the chorus, and the fact that I was just kind of like, Jonathan Davis still has it. Now, we would hear how good his vocals have gotten, you know, later down the line, but this one definitely still showed you that Korn can still rock and kick ass. I mean, I liked The Serenity of Suffering and The Paradigm Shift, but there was still something lacking, and this definitely was what we needed from them.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Blink-182 went very, very, heartfelt on this song right here. Angel wings at the bus stop. Hey, So there were shootings that happened. I think it was the shootings that happened in Texas. I'm not sure what this... I know it had something to do with some, you know, tragic thing that happened. And, you know, once again, for what it is, what did I say about Blink-182? It's got to have that intense moment. And right when the chorus hits, boom, just Travis Barker kicks ass on the drums. They actually use him in this situation. It just feels... right, and for some reason, when Blink-182 gets dark and serious, I like that better when they're more fooling around and, you know, doing songs like I Wanna Fuck a Dog in the Ass, or the seven, you know, words you can't say on TV song, the shit, piss, fuck, cunt, cocksucker, motherfucker, tits, fart, turn, twat one, that one. Like, I don't want to hear that Blink-182 anymore. I want to hear this one, where they can still put together great pop-punk songs and have a meaning to them that, you know, we can just all look back and just... you know, coerce on.
Burger King foot lettuce.
I will defend this song until the end. All I wanted was violence! To me, Asking Alexandria is like Bring Me the Horizon. I'll take the new stuff over the old stuff. Sure, the old stuff might be okay, but when I had heard the self-titled album of Asking Alexandria, I said, this is what they need to be. This is what they need to be. Not what they were doing before. You know, they were edgy teenagers back in the day. Now they have fully grown up and are fully taking advantage. I know it may seem like people are like, it sounds like Imagine Dragons. It sounds more like Papa Roach to me. Like, Born for Greatness-ish. But other than that, I love when the drums kick in. The guitar doesn't bug me that much. It's cool. It's sing-songy, and I like it. You know, back, you know, they're not edgy anymore. They're just trying... to be adults, and the music video was kick-ass too. I love that bloody, gory shit, just entertaining. But don't listen, don't watch the music video if you want to get into the song. You gotta listen to the song itself because you'll be able to get more listens in, and you'll be able to just kind of, you know, relieve yourself and go, maybe this thing wasn't as bad as I thought with all the without all the pauses. It's definitely one that I will defend this year because it is not as bad as people are making it out to be.
Burger King foot lettuce.
Once again, where did I Prevail come from? And why did they decide to mix trap in with their metalcore? I don't know. It works. So what the hell do I care?
Burger King foot lettuce.
The 1975 kind of throw us off guard. Yeah. So after the more trap-leaning Brief Inquirer into Online Relationships, hearing this song, People, was just kind of surprising because it was more rock-leaning. And I gotta say, I like it. I like it. Reminds me a lot of a new punk tune. And I think they need to do this more. Please do this more.
Burger King foot lettuce.
Slipknot had a big year. Their album We Are Not Your Kind came out. They did big hits off of that album, like Unsainted, Birth of the Cruel, you'll see later, wink wink. And then there was kind of a couple of songs on that album that were under the radar, and this is the first one that I have to mention. It goes a little something like this. People criticize it because it's the one where there's not a lot of unclean vocals. There is, but like, and it sounds more like Stone Sour, people say, but you know, it's not nothing we haven't heard from them before. They did it on Point 5 The Great Chapter, they did it a little bit on All Hope Is Gone, and I'm pretty sure if you go back and listen to Volume 3, they did it a little bit there too. I really, really like this thing. The chorus is catchy, and I love when the unclean vocals come in. Corey Taylor just shows you his massive amount of vocal range. In this one song, it's ridiculously amazing.
Burger King foot lettuce.
But I think still the best... well, I know I put Heaven as the best Blink-182 song from the album 9, but No Heart to Speak Of. I'm gonna slip away! I know I trashed Matt Skiba's song, Dark Side, on Worst Songs of the Year, spoiler on that, if you haven't seen the video, but this one. When I heard this song, I said, he's earned his right to be called a member of Blink-182. That vocal performance was so strong. I mean, that chorus, it was the best vocal performance on the album, and it was probably like the second or third best chorus overall on the album. I was just astonished and just was like, you know what? Applause, Mr. Skiba. Applause. Because that was what we've been waiting for. That was the talent we knew you had that could come out at any point in time, and it definitely, definitely did that.
Burger King foot lettuce.
So, Weezer is releasing an album in May of next year. They already released two this year, the Teal album, the Covers album, the one they played around with, and Black album, which was supposed to be their darkest album yet, but sorry, that still belongs to Pinkerton. Anyway, there was this that we got credited with. The End of the Game off of their new album, Van Weezer. If you couldn't tell by that guitar riff. They're going back to guitar-driven power pop. They said it's going to be a heavier version of the Blue album, basically. To me, it sounded more like stuff you get off the Green album and Maladroit. But goddamn am I excited. They played this song to promote the tour they're doing with Green Day and Fall Out Boy. Also to announce that the Van Weezer album is coming out, and I'm just like, what is 2019 for Weezer? People went from, they're done, we hate it, to, oh my god, this is what we wanted, they're back and doing everything. It's like, so up and down, Weezer, your career has been a roller coaster, but I love it. I love this thing. I was just so appalled when I'd heard this. I was like, we've been waiting for this for years, even 2014, with Everything Will Be Alright in the End, Return to Form, but we were kind of like, there's still that element missing, and they brought it back. They definitely reeled it in and brought it back.
Burger King foot lettuce.
So if you didn't like the first Slipknot song I mentioned, then you probably wouldn't have even known that this one is Slipknot without me telling you. Yeah, sounds very haunted housey. Spiders, it's eerie. It makes you feel like there's spiders crawling on you. You're like, ugh, God, get them off me. You know, especially if you hate spiders like I do. And once again, it was just another weird oddball on the album where you're going, this is Slipknot? There's no screaming. Corey Taylor's singing, but it's nothing he's ever did on Slipknot before. It was just very appalling and surprising. But hey, it worked. It's catchy as fuck, and I want them to make this a single. They're probably not going to, but I would love it if it was.
Burger King foot lettuce.
Not a big fan of Sleeping with Sirens, but when I heard Leaving All Behind, I gotta say, I didn't know they could get that heavy. Will you remember me if I really didn't know what to expect. I still don't like... oh god, I forgot his name's voice. I knew his name and now I don't remember. It's just like, why do you want to sing like that, especially when you're a man in your 30s? But whatever, I love the drums go hard, the guitars. It was like they took a complete U-turn, because I know what their last album sounded like. But then there was this and you're just kind of like, whoa, okay. They listened and went back to what they used to do. Congratulations. It got you in the top 5 for 2019 songs of the year.
Burger King foot lettuce.
Bring me the Horizon return for the final time on the list.
Oh, give me a break!
We have their song off of the Death Stranding Timefall soundtrack called Ludens. This came as an utter surprise for most because it starts off with something you might hear from like Ammo with the, you know, driven, the beat-driven, you know, kind of way, and the lyrics are actually quotes from the video game, which make it even cooler that it's kind of that. And then, you know, by the second chorus, you're getting the drums kicking in and all this, and then around the 2.5 minute mark, you just get the breakdown of all breakdowns that would make the old fans just so happy. And you're like, we didn't know they still had this in them. People were like, do they even still, is Ollie's voice is shot in? Not a lot of people listen to the end of heavy metal, I'll give them that. But hearing this, I think it made people go, maybe they were just doing different things. They didn't want to do this, but yeah, putting a breakdown in the middle of their new song kind of made fans wake up and go, what? Oh God, they can still do this? Holy crap. Not only that, it fit the atmosphere of the soundtrack for the video game too, so I found that to be, you know, good work done when you're able to, you know, put your song and make it feel like it belongs on a soundtrack, because sometimes you just kind of, bands just kind of phone it in for the money, but when you try really hard, this is the result you can get.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Speaking of the Death Stranding soundtrack, Churches hits us with the self-titled track. You can take my heart and hold it together as we fall. That's right. Death Stranding by Churches comes in at number 3. I love it. It was like a return to form for Churches, because Love is Dead was definitely all over the place with different kinds of sounds that they had never really done before. But it was, you know, I gotta say, a little too long for my liking, and Lara Mayberry's vocals may have been tampered with just a little bit too much. It was just cool hearing them go back to the regular synth pop, no, none of this like gimmick on it or whatever. It kind of felt like I was just back in the days of their debut album, The Bones of What You Believe. It definitely was one that made me go, oh, this is what I missed about them. Their first two albums, this is what I missed about them. I'm glad that they're back to this, at least for now. And once again, it fit the atmosphere of the video game soundtrack. It really felt like it belonged where it needed to be instead of them just half-assing this so much. And I've been playing on a repeat ever since.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
Oh, our runner-up for Song of the Year at number 2 is Slipknot. And to be honest with you, I wanted to put them at number 1, but I was like, they were number 1 last year with All Out Life, and I just felt like it was unfair to put them at number 1 again. And then one song came out before this that made me go, okay, yeah, Slipknot's number 2 this year. But this song deserves some love. It was another one where I was kind of like, meh, you know, it could grow on me, it might not, and it did. And now it's probably my favorite song off of We Are Not Your Kind. I mean, there's just a certain, I really love it. It's, I know I use this word a lot, but eerie and just dark, and I feel it from the verses, and then when Corey Taylor just lets it out, and then he goes, Birth of the Cruel! Birth of the Cruel! And he just holds it for so long, and you're like, yes, this is headbanging mosh pit shit right here. It kind of had a little bit of a Korn influence, you might say. So now, before we get to number 1, you know I gotta throw some honorable mentions at you. These songs were good, but not great enough to make the list, but still deserve some recognition, so let's get that started. Ooh, this shit bliss, I'm so rich. Ooh, abs like Abercrombie Fitch. St. Tropez, I really like the flow. Good track off of Post Malone's Hollywood's Bleeding. Ready with no family, with a pocket full of jam. Denzel Curry just fucking, look, I didn't expect this from a rapper at all. He kicked ass on it. And added his own verse into the song too, to make it, you know, fit with the times. Fucking 100, man. Weezer hit us with the poppier track, Living in L.A. Catchy tune. You know, gotta love it. Ozzy, still kicking it into his 70s. Under the Graveyard is breathtaking. It's like a main theme for some sort of, like, action movie. I really, really did enjoy it. Hello. Another one that grew on me, Hallucinations by Paris. You know what? I'll give it what it's worth. It's catchy. I fucking think that it has the potential to do a whole lot for them, and hopefully the song charts. I don't know, but, you know, meh.
Burger King Foot Lettuce.
So, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the number one pick. I don't know if you saw my wink at the end of number two when I had mentioned the Korn influence, but once again, I had contemplating putting Birth of the Cruel by Slipknot at number one because it was just so good. I'm like, maybe they deserve it 2 years in a row? I don't know. But then there was one song that came out by Korn that I heard, and I said, yeah, they've dethroned Slipknot from the number one spot this year, and this song is the reason why. I mean, you want to talk about Korn really getting people's interest back? How about the unclean vocals by Jonathan Davis on this song, Cold? You know, it starts off with the head-pounding drums and just the one guitar strum. You get the, you know, just raunchiness of Cold, you know, like the scattiness of Jonathan Davis's voice and the sing-along verses to the sing-along chorus and the little bridge right before the chorus where Jonathan Davis is giving off that little growl. It was just so perfect and probably the best vocal performance in a while by Jonathan Davis. I mean, I gotta say, I was impressed. I went off and I went like, yes. And since then, the song has not left my replay button. It is still playing on repeat. I'm listening to the song in my head right now. That is how much I love this thing. So yeah, guys, that does it. You guys can tell me in the comments below, what were your favorite songs of the year? What are some that you may disagree with me on? You can tell me in the comments below, and you can also make your own list. Up next will be the fourth and final part of the year end list, where I give you the best albums that came out of the in the year. Basically based on my opinion, you know how that goes. People will still hate me for it either way. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you're on Facebook, share, and I will catch you all in the next one.